Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Fantasy Football, and welcome to my video. Today, we're just going to be relaxing. We're just going to be chilling, and we're going to be going through my entire season. I also wanted to talk to you guys about some strategies that actually worked, and some strategies that did not work. I'm going to be announcing the league winners, and just going to go through some of the transfers that I made this season, and just a general talk about FPL, to be honest with you. Just to let you guys know that, you know, I create Champions League videos, so that will be out this weekend. I just need to log in and have a look at my team and make some adjustments before I create the video. So I wanted to mention that for you guys. But what a season it has been, especially 2020, like, I'm still in a lockdown, basically. As you can see, my hair and the way I look, I'm in lockdown. And I looked at the first few videos for this season, looked at how I looked. So let's just have a quick look. I mean, look at that. Look at this young man, and look at me now. What's happened? And that was my team. You know, for this season, it was the first game week, and it was a good ride. Like, I had a lot of fun. You know, I got a lot of passion for this game, and yeah, I don't know what's happened now. It's like a complete different person. I'm more like exhausted now. And on my Twitter, you know, I tried my best to go through and thank everyone as much as I can. There's still a lot of people that I need to go back, and this kind of content that I do is something that I love doing, and I love helping out. And you know, that's pretty much the goal. It's just to play the game and enjoy the game with you guys, experience the ups and downs, and basically like have something to do, and it's just, it helps that mind, you know, it helps that mind concentrate on something else. And on the way, you know, helping people out is what the aim is with this channel. And I'm pretty sure that I have the research that I do, it works. And it's just all about me making that final decision. But yeah, it's been a great, great run. I got, what, nearly 17,500 subscribers. It's been amazing. And next year, well, when I say next year, next season, sorry, I'm going all in, meaning that I am updating everything, the intro, the outro, the way it looks, like the thumbnails. I'm going to be trying to make it like unique, different. I don't want to go with this purple and green anymore. And I'm going to be looking at sponsorships that will help the channel, not hurt it, and things like that. And of course, I'm going to be collaborating with other YouTubers as well. People who has been on YouTube for such a long time. I wanted to give you guys basically more things to watch and give you guys more entertainment. Normally when I watch a YouTube channel, I just like to listen and be entertained by, you know, the things that people say. And I feel that it's relaxing in a weird way. But yeah, that's that. Let's move on. So game week 38, as you can see, played a free hit, but 74 points. That's really good considering my captain blanked. As you can see, above the average of 60, and I did gain about 10 to 15,000 rank, which was good, but I did a big mistake by removing Kevin De Bruyne. I think I did mention, like, you got to be quite careful when you use your free hit. When you're removing big players, it could bite you. But I tried to do something just a little bit different, not too much. As you can see, I had Salah in my team in the video, but I found that he was benched. And this was like 10 to 15 minutes before the deadline, so there was quite a lot of time to kind of make some changes. I removed Salah and I thought, what can I do? You know what? Let's go for it. Bought in Mahrez, got 9 points. Bought in Aubameyang, but still could have managed to get into the top 100k. It's just that captain option. Went for David Silva. I tried to do something a little bit different. didn't pay off. However, I'm happy the fact that most of my players that I bought in bought some big returns, like Aubameyang was 16, Ings, Kane, Fernandes, Sterling, Mahrez. These are big points. And these are the players that I mentioned on my videos. So, yeah. And as you can see on the bench, I had a lot of money. And I thought, you know what, let's just put Jack Grealish there just in case one of my players doesn't play. He actually scored. And, you know, the bench here that I was not going to use anyway. But pretty decent there. And, you know, I'm looking at the players that I mentioned. Most of them worked, which was a good thing. So the research on looking into wildcard and free here, it does work. It's all about when to use it. Now, would I use my free hit again in Game Week 38? No. You know those game weeks, like Game Week 37 and Game Week 35, where I mentioned that my team is not good enough? I should have used it in those game weeks. I felt that my team wasn't good enough, and I should have used it in those game weeks that could have maybe got me into a better rank. So moving forward, I am not going to be using it in Game Week 38 unless I don't have a complete team, like good team for that week. I think my team was decent enough. But looking back now, I think, yeah, I should have used it before. So that was the thing that I could have changed. However, you know, these things can happen. Last year, I was more disappointed, and I had a lot more pressure in some kind of way. And I was a little bit stressed as well. But this season, I'm just like, you know what? It's 2020. Anything can happen. And I just want to play the game and enjoy it. And to be honest with you, since the restart, I did, you know, game, I was around 250k. Went to 110. That's not bad. Anyways, let's move on. It happens, we move on. And looking at the season, like, overall, I mean, for me, I've been quite consistent, I think. And this is what I want to do. Try and be up into that, you know, that 100k mark, and give you guys as much as information as possible to help you. And that is it. If I can get better, you know, if I can get into the top 10k or 1000, oh my god, I'll probably get millions of views. But yeah, it's not too bad. It's not too bad. But anyways, let's move on. Okay, now let's quickly talk about the things that I really want to do next season and how am I going to play the game. Number one is not to use my free hit in Game Week 38. I think the free hit is very strong for a game week that is a blank or a double game week. I think that helps out a lot. The next thing is to remove a player that is just not performing. Just like Sigurdsson. Remember that I bought Sigurdsson and I had him for such a long time? And then, yeah. Not going to do that anymore. Not going to be holding a player just because they got an amazing fixtures. Not going to be doing that again. I think looking at it, the captain option is so important. That is so, so important. So I've got to try and nail in on those captain options. I think my team is always going to do well. It's just getting that extra points from your captain. And the thing that I need to adapt is removing a player earlier. So just like Sigurdsson, like Perez, or any other player that I had in my team for like a number of weeks and I didn't remove, I need to remove those players quicker. Not like in one go, just because they blanked one game, but I got to stop looking at the fixtures and just looking at the player itself. So that's my two things. The second part, obviously, I can adjust. The first part, you know, getting a captain right, sometimes you do need the luck, you know, you need that luck. But I'm going to go for big players and not like small players. You know, Salah, De Bruyne, Sterling, players that could, you know, get so much points and will definitely help you out. And have at least two captain options instead of having like so many. I think that will help out with the captain options every week. But yeah, those are the adjustments that I need to make. But I think that's about it. I think the chip strategies and stuff like that, I think it went really well. I don't think there was any problem. I think the free hit could have been better. I think in a normal season, I wouldn't use my free hit in Game Week 38 anyway. I think I would use it on a blank game week or maybe in a double. But we'll see. But anyways, let's go on to the league winners. So, the league winners. Now, Second Chance is a league where I created on the restart of the Premier League. Started from Game Week 30, and I said that whoever wins, they will be mentioned on my video. And, you know, if you want to be mentioned more, or if you want to join, let me know. Follow me on Twitter and DM me, and we can always sort that out for next season. And next season is just around the corner anyway. And as you can see, the winner of Second Chance is Donovan. Well done to you with a whopping 756 points. Let's have a quick look at his team. I'm not going to go through like the histories and stuff like that. You know, that's all personal stuff. But please let me know if you want to be on one of my videos for next season. We're just going to go through your team quite quickly for Game Week 38. Overall rank of 7,420. Fantastic. Didn't use the free hit. Obviously, couldn't get any clean sheet points because of the number of goals that happened in Game Week 38. But really good team here. Kept Kevin De Bruyne. I got Sterling. Captained him. David Silva, Martial, Fernandes, midfielders done really well. Ings, Greenwood. And obviously it was that moment where is it viable to kind of remove any Manchester United players or just to keep? Looks like you kept them, which is a good move there because you got Martial, points and Fernandes. And you benched Raul Jimenez, which is interesting. But yeah, really good team, 70 points. Really good rank as well. Well done to you. Now, my main league, Cap Canucks. The league that started from game week one. And they actually got some prizes on there. Meaning that the third person, which is Marco, wins £25. Let's have a quick look at his team. With a whopping 2,455 points. That is incredible. That is incredible. Let's just have a quick look at his team. Overall rank of 260. I hope I have helped. 56 points. As you can see, Captain David Silva went for the same pick as me. Went for that dream pick. Kevin De Bruyne was the main guy. Walker Peters got 6 points there for you. Jesus. You got the Manchester United players. Obviously, you didn't remove Salah. Maybe you could have moved him, or maybe there was just no other options for you. But yeah, I mean, 56 isn't the best for Game Week 38, but you got a whopping amazing rank. So, you know, you should be over the moon no matter what. But yeah, let's have a quick look at the bench. Okay, Zuma. I mean, I wouldn't play him anyway, but yeah, cool. Really good team. Well done to you. £25 is coming up to you. And as you can see, the runner-up, Liam, with a whopping 93 points in Game Week 38 and total points of 2,478 points. Wow. Well done to you. You will receive a whopping £50 note. Well, it's not going to be a note. It's actually going to be from PayPal. But still, 93 points, played the free hit, worked out really well. Do you have Kevin De Bruyne? I bet you have. And yes, you do. You've got Kevin De Bruyne, Sterling. Let's just position this nicely. Martinez. Okay, you got Robertson points there. I think it's an assist. Sterling as a captain. Fernandes with 11. De Bruyne with 19. You got David Silva as well. Kane, Ings. Aubameyang, I think this is pretty much one of the best free hits that you can ever do. Having Kevin De Bruyne, pretty similar team as mine. I just don't have Kevin De Bruyne and I didn't go for Sterling. You can see just one or two things different. does make a lot of difference. And the overall rank of 95 rank. That is incredible. Please DM me on Twitter. We will sort out the payment. But yeah, well done to you. Now here we go. The first position of Capkanites. Well done to you is Christopher. Well done with a whopping 81 points in Gaming 38 and 2,502 points total for the whole season. Well done to you, my friend. You have won £100. Please follow me on Twitter, DM me, and then we can sort this out. As you can see, 32. He's ranked 32 in the world. Can we swap ranks just for a day? 81 points. Well done to you, mate. Took a minus 4 point hit. Let's have a quick look at the team. Pretty similar, but went with Song, Captain Sterling, kept Kevin De Bruyne, went for Mahrez, Fernandez there as well, Greenwood, Kane. You got Wan-Bissaka points. You got the extra points from Robertson. Not many managers actually has him in their team. Connolly. I looked at Connolly as well. Okay, 8 points there. Well done to you, my friends. Incredible, of a overall rank of 32. Well done. So that was it. Those were the winners of my leagues. Please DM me. I'll try my best to figure out who is who. And once I have done that, I will start giving you guys the prize. And yeah, I think that is pretty much it. 74 points is not too bad. Overall rank of 110. I'm pretty happy. I'm happy the fact that I have helped as much as I can. And, you know, that's the goal. And yeah, this season was actually quite tough for a lot of FPL managers out there. Next season, I'll be doing things a little bit different. I'm going to be updating my channel, new thumbnail, new intro. I already started already. I am going to be doing a lot more on the leagues. I'm going to be maybe creating a paid league as well, where there's going to be a bigger prizes. And obviously a public one as well, so there'll be options, so do not worry about that. And yeah, there's going to be a lot of things, guys. Don't forget, my next video will be the Champions League one, and then after that I will be creating my thoughts for the next season with the new intros, with the new outros, with everything brand new for you guys to see. Okay, yeah, anyways, hope you guys enjoy this. Sit back, relax. If you need any help, if you want to talk about things, follow me on Twitter. That's where I can try my best to help you guys out. And that is it. Watch out for my videos. And I'll see you guys. Well, I was going to say next season. It's going to be after this weekend. But see you guys next time. See ya.